Hi, I'm Jim Kleinpeter, LSU beat writer for NOLA.com, the Times-Picayune, with a draft report on LSU players. It was a bad day for the Collinses on Thursday. For that matter, all three Collinses, as Alabama safety Landon Collins was not picked in the first round. He was rated the number one safety by most draft analysts, but did not go. LSU's two Collins boys, Lyle Collins and Jalen Collins, were also passed over. No big surprise that Lyle Collins was passed over, although he had been rated by some as maybe the best tackle in the draft. He is beset by a lot bigger problems than where he's going to be drafted. He's wanted for questioning in the murder of his ex-girlfriend, Brittany Mills, but he is not a suspect in the case. But when that came to light on Tuesday, the NFL teams that prized him or had him high on their draft boards backed off. They all passed on him. It's not known how far he's going to fall, but I don't think it's likely he's going to be picked on Friday either when the second and third rounds commence. Maybe there's an outside chance somebody takes a shot late in the third round, but that's still a pretty high pick to waste on somebody that you don't know if you're going to have. So Lyle Collins is going to meet with police after the draft, but I think the damage has been done, and he could fall as far as the seventh round or maybe not be drafted at all, which would be a shame, but it is what it is. So it's real life what's going on with him right now. Jalen Collins, a cornerback, also ran into some lesser off-field issues when it was revealed that he failed multiple drug tests while at LSU, and he was looked at as a first possible late first round pick. He got past the Packers. The Green Bay Packers took a safety instead of him, a guy that could probably play corner a little bit, so a good cover guy. They also passed on Landon Collins, and so you have to wonder about that. But Jalen Collins, I think, will go in the first half of the second round, a place where maybe the Saints could grab him, although the Saints are also still looking for an edge rusher after spending their first two picks in the first round on an offensive tackle and a linebacker. So we'll see where Jalen Collins falls. I don't think he should fall too far, especially if the NFL digs into the details of his positive drug tests at LSU and finds that perhaps these were committed during his redshirt freshman or during his freshman season when he redshirted. He played three seasons after that, so he's a four-year college guy, which should help. He's 6'1", 203, and could match up well, be a good get in the second round. It just remains to be seen how far he might fall. Landon Collins, everybody thought he'd be a first-round pick, but he slid steadily down, probably due to a lack of his coverage skills. The NFL, a safety is going to be a lot more valuable if he can really cover people, and Landon Collins is almost like a hybrid player between linebacker and safety. There's no doubting his ability in the box. That's what type of safety he is. Danielle Hunter is a guy who's coming up. He's one of the LSU players that's moved up, and his stock is rising. It's very possible that he gets picked before Jalen Collins, which I would think would have been a surprise a few weeks ago. So we'll see how that goes today on Friday when the second and third rounds. I'm Jim Kleinpeter. Follow all our draft coverage on NOLA.com.